Intel's Architecture Day happened, and oh boy, is it nice to see something new coming from Intel. There was a lot of info in there, so let's break it down on your boot sequence. The name Sunny Cove is actually the name of the core architecture itself and not the actual chip family. If I understood things correctly, that would for example mean that Ice Lake would be comprised of Sunny Cove cores, similar to how AMD uses the name Zen for their core architecture, but uses Ryzen or Threadripper as the chip name. Then we had the roadmap. Sunny Cove is the start of this 10 nanometer journey, and it will launch next year, followed by Willow Cove in 2020 and Golden Cove in 2021. Willow Cove is likely to still be at 10 nanometers, while Golden Cove will probably get the 7 nanometer treatment. With Sunny Cove, we also got our first look at the 11th generation of Intel integrated graphics. What we saw was an Ice Lake U CPU. The U means that it is an ultra low power chip, and they ran a demo with Tekken 7 comparing it to Intel's Skylake CPU with a 9th gen integrated graphics. In case you were wondering though, Intel's 9th gen iGPU hasn't been around in the desktop processor since the 6700K, so it's a pretty old iGPU to compare it with. Nonetheless, according to Anantech, it looked way smoother but still had trouble running at a full 30 FPS. So, will this beat a current Intel NUC with Vega inside or the possible next generation Ryzen with Navi inside? I highly doubt it. Now, for the interesting part of the event, we have the design of their next CPUs. Intel is going to abandon the idea of going with a monolithic die and go it, wait for it,
chiplet, and I think you will find others in the industry adopting this in more and more ways.
He showed you why chiplets were so important.
Just like AMD. Okay, they're not actually abandoning monolithic dies completely. I mean, Raja Koduri made it clear during a Q&A session, but it looks like Intel will change the way their chips are made. They're going to use their EMIB to connect multiple chiplets of various densities. This will allow for improved yields, better costs, and better time to market. Intel has been considering doing this for a long time. Sure, they had their mesh interconnect, but that system didn't allow the same level of flexibility as AMD's multi-layered Infinity Fabric. This newer EMIB style interconnect could allow for something like this, and yes, I know that it's similar to what AMD is doing with EPYC. They did push it one step further thanks to what they call Foveros. Foveros is similar to EMIB or AMD's Infinity Fabric, but it moves in an extra dimension. Instead of putting all of the chips side by side, they're going to stack them in the same way that HBM memory is made. I don't think that this Foveros 3D stacking will happen in the high end of their CPUs though. It is well suited for low power parts, but if they stack the high performance cores on top of each other, the thermals are bound to make some damage. I'm just glad that Intel is finally thinking about putting their EMIB to good use. So far, it was only used in Kaby Lake G chips in cooperation with AMD, and it was a way to connect a monolithic CPU and a GPU, not to connect, let's say, a chiplet with another chiplet like AMD does. I know it was also used on their Knights Landing CPU, but I like to focus on consumer stuff. Alright, so after talking about their new CPUs for a while, they finally got to their GPU, and they're calling it the XE, or Z, or X to the power. Anyways, they unveiled their plans for their discrete GPUs, and honestly, it looks like they want to take AMD and Nvidia head on. Their slides show that the product stack will go from integrated graphics and entry models, to mid-range, to enthusiasts, all the way up to data center products. That means that we'll have a GPU solution for everyone. Of course, we don't have any kind of information on performance, so I guess we'll have to wait until then to see. It's only about a year and a half out, not too bad. So I know that my comment section is going to be filled with whatever, I'm just gonna wait for Ryzen 3000, and who cares about Intel, and I get it. The main thing any of us are really thinking about is price to performance, so I still hope that AMD will continue to give Intel a run for its money, because it's the only way we're gonna get competitive pricing. Remember when AMD came out with a Ryzen 1800X? It was $500. The price only dropped to about $350 once it had competition with the 8700K. The same is happening with the next gen Ryzen. The rumors say that the new Ryzen 9 series will be around $500, and I don't think that it will change unless Intel puts some pep into their 10 nanometer step. So think about it, it's good to have Intel perform as well as AMD, because AMD is always going to lower their price and eat some of their market share. Alright, so this is it for the Intel roundup. Don't forget to drop a comment down below, let me know what you thought, because a lot of interesting topics here. Leave a like if you liked it, and click right here to see the latest video, and right here to subscribe to the channel. It would, as usual, be greatly appreciated. As always, stay frosty, and I'll see you guys on the next video.
He told you why we chose 7 nanometer. He showed you why chiplets were so important.